God bless you, dear friend, for joining us once again on Jesus Clinic. It's a great opportunity and always a privilege to bring the word of God unto you. Today, God has sent me to bring a message of hope. I'm just praying that God, through the words of my mouth, will restore joy, strength, faith, and hope unto his people. Wherever you are, I'd like you to know that it's not by chance that you have tuned into this ministration. And I believe that God is going to strengthen you through his undiluted word. If you are ready, let us pray. Heavenly Father, thank you, because your word is power. Your word is life. I pray for as many people as are watching, as many people as are listening from wherever they are right now, that you will use, oh God, the word of my mouth and bring hope, encouragement, strength, and joy unto your children. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen. Today, I just want to share the word of God with you, and my topic is, in times like this, for such a time as this that we are in our nation, we all know the things that we are going through in our nation. The past 2, 3, 4 weeks, steadily, things seem to be collapsing. Things seem to be getting tighter and tighter for the middle class and the low class. Many people are becoming more despondent. Many people are becoming more hopeless. Many people are feeling more pains. Our economy seems to be getting worse. In times like this, we have received news of increase in electricity tariff. We have received news of increase in price of fuel, price of kerosene. For those of us that use cable television, we have received increase in tariff for DSTV. The central bank recently announced, in the midst of all this increase, they reduced the interest rate on savings from 3.7 to 1.5. I mean, inflation is rising. Inflation is now at about 12.5%. Many people are losing their jobs. Those who are holding some jobs are underemployed. Those who are still holding their jobs are not being paid salaries. You hear of many institutions, many organizations owing their workers 2 months, 3 months, 5 months. I even heard of a state that is owing their workers for 11 months. You know, I know that my people are going through a difficult time. In times like this, what do we do? You that is listening to me right now, I don't know what you may be personally going through. I don't know how this is hitting you hard. I don't know your own losses. I don't know your own predicament. I don't know your own confusion. I don't know your own pains. But I just want us to meditate together on the word of God. And I will read from the book of Psalms. Psalms number 121. The psalmist says, I lift up my eyes to the hills. I lift up my eyes to the hills. Some translation says to the mountains. Whether you call it hills or mountains, they are talking about fortified places, strong places, reliable places. The psalmist says, I lift my eyes to the hills. I will survey the strong places, the fortified places, the reliable places, places that one can have confidence in. And he asked the question, where does my help come from? Will my help come from these fortified places? Will my help come from these reliable places? Will my help come from these seemingly stable places? The reason why I'm reading this psalm is because many of us have been disappointed by our mountains. Many of us have been disappointed by the places that we looked up to, the big men we trusted, the jobs we trusted, our businesses we trusted, our bank accounts we trusted, people that make promises to us that we trusted, people that before now we could easily run to that we trusted, our connections. I mean, the things that we could fall back on, they have failed many of us. They have failed many of us. The psalmist says, where does my help come from? He answered the question in verse 2. He says, my help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. Dear friend, in a time like this, in a time like this, when we see things falling apart, what are the choices before us? What are the choices before us? You know, like I said in one of my past messages, we really have two options. We have two options. In one of the options, we can decide in a time like this, with all the disappointments, with all the lack, with all the economic hardship, we can decide to be hopeless. We can decide to be despondent. We can decide to grumble, murmur, and complain. It's a choice. Anybody can decide to be negative. We can decide to be fatalistic or pessimistic. We can decide to give up and wallow in self-pity. But God forbid, that will not be a good choice for you. We can decide to look for who to blame. We can blame the president. We can blame this party or blame the other party. But would that really solve our personal problems? Would that really solve our individual problems? This moment, as you are listening to me, I want to give you a choice. I want to give you the right choice that will help you to move on with life, that will help you to hold on to life, no matter how low you have fallen, no matter how bad things have become. In the book of Habakkuk, chapter 3, the prophet Habakkuk said in verse 17, though the fig tree does not bud, and there are no grapes on the vine, though the olive crop fails, and the fields produce no food, though there are no sheep in the pen, and no cattle in the stalls. Verse 18, hallelujah. He says, yet I will rejoice in the Lord, hallelujah. I will be joyful in God my Savior. All of us are feeling the pains of the devastations happening in our country. All of us are going through the losses, the joblessness, the unemployment, the loss of jobs. All of us are going through the economic, material, and financial hardships. Prices of goods and essential commodities are going up higher and higher and higher. Yes, but the prophet says, no matter what is happening, no matter what is happening to my bank account, no matter what is happening to my pocket, no matter what is happening in my kitchen, no matter what is happening in my storehouse, no matter what is happening in my on my dining table, no matter how I feel now, he says, I will rejoice in the Lord. I will be joyful in God my Savior. What is the prophet saying? He is saying, I will hold on to God. I will keep hope alive. I will keep faith alive. I will keep rejoicing. Why? Why? In that Psalm number 121, the psalmist said, He will not let your foot slip. He who watches over you will not slumber. Indeed, he who watches over Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. Dearly beloved, child of God, I repeat, it is not by accident that you are listening to me now. Maybe you are the very person God sent me to talk to. You are losing hope. You're becoming suicidal. You're becoming more negative than positive. You have stopped pursuing your visions. You have stopped believing in your dreams. The word of God says, the Lord will keep you from all harm. He will watch over your life. The Lord will watch over your coming and going, both now and forever. These are promises that do not depend on the economy of the nation. I am not making excuses for the government. I am not making excuses for those in authority. But I'm concerned about you. I'm concerned about you. I'm concerned about your tomorrow. I want you to keep your joy. I want you to keep faith alive, because this is the only thing that can pull you through. I want you to keep hope alive, because this is the only thing that can pull you through. Instead of being hopeless, remain hopeful. Instead of living in doubt, fear, anxiety, panic, frustration, keep faith alive. Keep believing God. Keep trusting God that He will come to you personally and turn things around for you, no matter what is going on around you. And in a time like this, the second thing that we need to do, apart from keeping hope alive, keeping faith alive, keeping our joy, I want us to rise up in prayer for our nation, Nigeria. Only God will deliver this nation. Only God will save this nation. Our leaders don't have the solution. They have lost ideas. They have lost, plans. Only God will save Nigeria. Only God will save you and I. Only God will bring us out of this situation we have found ourselves in. No man can help us. They are not thinking about us. God is the only one that can deliver us from devastation, from hunger, from poverty, from lack. The ropes seem to be tightening on our neck. But we need to rise up in prayer and ask God to deliver this nation from economic devastation, to deliver this nation from penury, from desolation. Only God can deliver us and redistribute the wealth of this nation. This is a blessed nation, but few people have pocketed the wealth of this nation. This is a blessed nation, but few people are stacking up cash in their houses. There are people, if you go to their houses, you will see a room full of dollars, pound sterling, euro, naira, from floor to roof. While a minute from that house, 2 minutes from that house, 5 minutes from that house, there's a family that has not seen food to eat. It is God that can rise up and discomfit the wicked in their wickedness. It's only God that can rise up and change the status in this nation. So apart from encouraging you to keep your faith, to keep hope alive, to keep your joy, not to be despondent, not to give up, I want to encourage you day and night to pray for this nation. Nigeria needs to be delivered. Nigeria needs to be redirected. In times like this, we need God. Only God. Only God. Nobody. Nobody can deliver this nation. No political party can deliver this nation. No kind of government can deliver this nation. God will arise and raise new crop of people, and raise new crop of leaders, and raise a different set of leaders who will be passionate about the commoners, about the citizenry. That is what we need in this nation. In time like this, what I'm saying today is, we don't need to be hopeless. We don't need to be despondent. We don't need to commit suicide. We don't need to lose standard. We don't need to run into corruption. We don't need to rush into prostitution. We don't need to soil our hands. But we need to keep hope alive, keep faith alive, keep believing God, keep trusting God, and thirdly, we need to rise up in prayers for this nation. Today, as I end this ministration, my heart goes out for all the people, all the parents that cannot put food on the table for their children. My heart goes out for all those who are sick and cannot afford medication. My heart goes out for those who have no channel of income, for those whose shops and businesses have closed down for months now. My heart goes out for all those who are confused, who are stranded, for those who are almost giving up in life. And I want to pray with you. Wherever you are right now, I'd like you to stretch your two hands. Stretch it to God, not to me. Stretch it to God, the merciful God, the Lord who saves the poor and the needy. As you lift your hands to Him, His mighty hands will come down upon you. I speak to you as an agent of God. Father, everyone lifting his or her hands right now, wherever they may be, oh God, we may be physically separated, but we are connected now in the spirit. As their hands rise up to you, let your mighty hands come down to them. Deliver your people from desolation, from hunger, from destitution. Deliver your people, O God, from sicknesses. I pray, O God, anyone listening to me now who is sick, let your healing power come upon their physical body. Deliver them right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Those, O God, who have been so challenged that they are running into iniquity, Lord, I drag them back. I call them back. Lord, I pray that you will arrest them, bring them back to salvation and righteousness. In the name of Jesus Christ, those who are hungry, who do not have what to eat, who do not have what to present before their children, miracle God, provide for them. You are that same God that provided manna in the wilderness. You are that same God that fed 5,000 with 5 small loaves and 2 fish. You are that same God that brought money from the mouth of a fish in the ocean. I pray that you will give your people their own miracle, their own testimonies. Those that have lost their jobs and businesses so far, give them another channel of income. Those that have been disappointed and betrayed, Father, I pray that you will minister comfort unto them. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I speak strength into you. I speak hope into you. I speak joy into you. Rise up and be strong in the name of Jesus Christ. And Father, we lift our hands to you. We pray for Nigeria, O God. Deliver this nation, O God, from those who have arrested it. Deliver this nation from those that are killing it. Deliver this nation from those that are devastating it. Lord, intervene for the sake of the poor masses. Heal Nigeria. Recover Nigeria. Let the blessings of this nation be used to cater even for the citizenry. Lord, we ask that you raise up righteous leaders. Raise up men and women, O God, who will be patriotic. Raise up men and women, O God, who will think about the populace In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, our Father and our God, we ask, O God, that righteousness will flow in our streets, will flow in our government, will flow in our offices, will flow everywhere, on the mountains and in the valley, all to your own glory. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Remain strong. Remain hopeful. The light of God will shine even in the midst of darkness. I want to encourage you to share this message with all your friends on all social media platforms available to you. People need to be encouraged. People need to know that it is not over. Wherever you are, click share. Share this message. And I want you to like all our channels so that whenever our messages come up, you will be alerted. If you need further counseling and prayers, there is a number right now on the screen. Please send a message to that number. You will be attended to. Until we meet again, remain blessed. In Jesus' name, amen.